dreaming of all the days that lie ahead. With you, I'll be with you until the very end.
Glory has arrived in Дорогі гості, всі присутні, рідні, близькі, друзі, сьогодні є радісний день. Ми на весіллі. І так як невіста прийшла, жених є, є сьогодні у нас весілля. І перед тим, як ми розпочнемо щось тут робити, говорити, я хотів би, щоб ми склонили наші голови і просто дали дозвіл Ісусу Христу керувати цим весіллям і шлюбним наставленням. Давайте помолимося. Дорогий Ісус, ми дякуємо Тобі за Твою велику любов і милість до нас, за Твою ласку кожний день. Особливо сьогодні, коли ми чуємо голос жениха і невісти, і коли ми можемо жити в країні, де мирне небо, ми дякуємо Тобі, наш Ісус. І ми просимо, нехай Твоє благословіння буде сьогодні над молодим і молодою, щоби в сьогоднішній день їхні серця, так як вони захотіли з'єднати своє життя разом, були з'єднані назавжди. І тому прошу, благослови молодого, молоду, благослови мене, дай мені слово від Тебе, щоб воно було добрим і воно прийнялося цими молодими людьми, і ці слова були благословіння для їхнього життя. Ми дякуємо Тобі і величаємо Твоє святе ім'я. Ти один достойний слави. Амінь. А зараз ви можете сісти, і я хотів би в декількох словах просто сказати, що сьогодні не така, вам сказати, і проста, а не таке просте весілля. Сьогодні жениця нашого жениха ім'я є Еммануїл. Якщо ви знаєте, що це значить, що Бог з нами. І біля нього є, стоїть Заряна. Це наша зірка. І так якось два цих імені, вони просто говорять нам про багато. І тому я, знаєте, перед тим, як розпочинати це шлюбне наставлення, не казав, що давайте покличемо Ісуса Христа, а давайте звернемося до Нього, тому що Він вже з нами. Саме ім'я жениха каже, що Бог з нами. І, Зорянка, тобі повезло просто. От ти завжди будеш називати Його ім'я, і ти будеш просто на весь світ провозглашати, що Бог з нами. Це буде чудова сім'я. А тобі зранку дуже легко буде вставати. Ти так глянув, є тебе зірка. І все, і треба вставати. Так що вам вдвом дуже-дуже пощастило. Хай вас Бог благословить. А ви знаєте, що сьогодні буде нелегка задача. Мені треба буде розмовляти на мові, на язику і language. Так що ви всі, будь ласка, пильнуйте за тим, щоб ви зрозуміли, але я буду пильнувати основне, щоб молода і молоді сьогодні зрозуміли це наставлення. Ми провели з ними 6 тижнів уроків до шлюбного наставлення, pre-marriage counseling. І ми розмовляли на всякі теми, але ми знаємо, що життя воно настільки є непросте, і всі теми життя ми не змогли пройти. І тому я сьогодні хочу поставити цей шлюб на рейси, на фундамент Слова Божого. І щоб ви зрозуміли тільки, що один Господь Бог, якщо ви йому дозволите, він зможе скріпити ваш шлюб. Can hold your marriage together. If you will allow him. So, in the beginning, when God created the heaven and the earth and everything in it, God created Adam. And he has entrusted Adam the greatest work, the work that we still reap benefits of, naming all of the creation. And Adam was busy working. And God would come and have a communion with Adam. They would fellowship. And one time God came and he saw Adam and he found that there is something missing, but he had forethought this long ago before he even created Adam. The missing link was a helper, a suitable helper for Adam. And I know, Emik, you've been hard at work in church and busy establishing yourself, creating wealth, so your family will be good. God saw all your hard work, and he today is giving you Zarana to help you to achieve everything that God had purposed or predestined for you on this earth. And it is not some kind of a acquaintance or something that was a man for thought. It was God's idea that you would meet her one day, and her bright rays of Zarana would just captivate your heart, and you two would get together and today form a family. So be happy, be joyful, because what's happening today, it is God's will, and God's blessing is on you too. Knowing you, Emik, for I think like 12 years or even more, you always thought after God, and you were there to help other people in need. I know it, because when I needed help building a house, you came and you put on some soffits around the house, and every day I come and look up, I see your generous heart. And that generosity doesn't end here. I know how much more God will do through you, and how much more he will be able to do through you, both of you. And Zarana, you're like this amazing young lady that appeared in 2018, and I saw how relentlessly you practiced and you sang to worship and praise God, and that's just the beginning. God has purposed something much greater for both of you, and today you're stepping into the destiny that was forethought by God. And so be happy, rejoice. What you're doing today is the right thing to do, and God is pleased with you. So the purpose of marriage also, when God created a man and a woman, is to give birth to children so generations can continue and people can continue on the earth. And although most of the responsibility and most of the pain will come your way, you will also have to share in that responsibility. So the purpose of marriage is to bring forth human beings into the world. And because you have got to know God, God is entrusting you that you will raise your children according to biblical standards, and that people that will go after us will know God. So that is the responsibility that falls on both of you, and this is also a purpose of a marriage. I would like to continue with this theme of purpose of marriage. To make sure your marriage is successful, I would have to talk to the parents for a bit, if you guys excuse me. So, коли Бог створив Адама, а потім дав йому Єву, то він сказав такі гарну таку промову, що прийде час, коли молодий хлопець влюбиться у молоду дівчину, то він залишить, он оставить своєго папу і свою маму, залишить маму і приліпиться, приклеїться к своїй жені, і вони стануть одною плоттю. І сьогодні запитання, перед тим, як я далі буду говорити з молодими людьми, до вас, батьки, щоб вони приклеїлись, щоб вони зліпилися разом, приліпилися, вони повинні бути відпущеними вами, благословенні вами, творити свою сім'ю. Олександр, тата, Ліля, ви готові відпустити сьогодні? Благословляєте? Роза, ви благословляєте? Слава Богу! Вау! We can continue. That's good. I just thought of this. Я кішо подумав. Ліля і Роза. Але прекрасний букет на сьогодні. Ну, такі імена просто підібрали. О, дуже радісний день сьогодні. Слава Богу. Емік, for you there will be some instructions and the majority of responsibilities that we're going to talk about today. And for her is just a couple of verses. So are you ready for your instructions? Okay, I'm going to fold this in the right direction and we're going to begin. Emik, husbands ought to be considerate of their wives and love them like Christ loved the church. The responsibility of loving your wife is far beyond of the benefits that you can get out of her living here on earth. They go far beyond, because the love that you should show to your wife is on the same level, Bible says, as Christ showed to the church. And what did Christ do for the church? He has given himself up. He died so we may live. That means your ultimate goal is to make her happy, and in every way, physically, emotionally, and spiritually well. That is your ultimate responsibility. And do it with gentleness, with love, to the extent of if there is a need to lay your life down for her. Some say it's a harsh thing to say, but God forbid anything happens to her, she needs a kidney, and you check out, your kidney works for her. You shouldn't be like waiting, hey, let's look for somebody else. You'd be like, hey, I got one. Here you go, honey. I want you to live. That sounds, you know, kind of interesting, but this is the extent of love that we should have for our wives. And it says in 1 Peter chapter 3 that they are a gracious gift of life and we share in it. So we need to care for them with respect and honor so nothing will hinder us in our prayers. If you want God to hear your prayers, treat your wife with respect, love, and kindness. Otherwise, if your wife is upset and she's not happy, you're going to be praying and God is going to not hear your prayer until you go and make peace and show love and kindness to your wife. This is interesting because the Bible says when you're offering your gift, when you're offering a sacrifice and you're on your way to the altar, and you remember that somebody has something against you, leave that gift, run and make peace with whomever is upset with you, come back and then bring sacrifice. In the same way, when you are going to go to prayer in the afternoon, in the evening, in the morning, and you know that she is sad, before praying, you gotta be running and say, honey, you gotta be calling, forgive me. Is there anything I can do? Make peace. And then you know, whatever you pray, God hears your prayer. Important. In Ephesians chapter 5, verse 21, we find that there is not only the lordship that we should have over the wives, but we must use that lordship in humility and kindness. It says, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church, give himself up for her. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. Do you know that your wife, her well-being, her smile is a crown on your head? So if your wife is sad, imagine yourself, you're walking down the street and you have tears flowing out of your head and people looking at you and you say, something's wrong with you. Things don't add up. So if you're going to love her and make sure she's well taken care of, you're going to look good. You're going to look good. In other passages, it says that after you two get married, we pray for you and you get the blessing of the Lord, your husband and wife, your bodies don't belong to each other. Yeah, your body belongs to him, his body belongs to you. Kind of swap. You don't see it, you know, with your eyes, but in the spiritual world it is. So you got to care that that body is well taken care of because that's you. Corinthians chapter 13 is giving us an insight of what godly love is, the qualities of love. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. It means that if you will truly love her, you will be kind to her. And then if you're kind to her, you will care for her that she will succeed in everything, because out of her success, you will benefit. You should be proud of her how she is, but not be arrogant and proud of yourself, because your accomplishment will be shown in her. Love does not dishonor. You should never use any faulty language, anything that would cause any kind of discomfort from your words. The only language should come out of your mouth is a blessing every day, is to tell her how beautiful she is. Like, it's easy, I mean, you can see. But in life, you know, things take different directions, and sometimes it gets busy and that. And then even if you come in and, you know, it's not the way you expected it, brother, few kind words will put a smile on her face and everything will change for your benefit, Not self-seeking, not easily angered. You should not be getting upset for any reason, because as soon as you get upset, everything goes down the hill. I had this guy come up to me and he shared this story. During the wedding ceremony, a pastor given advice to a groom, and he said that when you come home and you see your wife angry, just go outside and just spend some time outside. And he took that advice very serious. And then what happened was 20 years later, they got together, and the pastor says, how is the marriage going? He goes like, well, after we got married, I live outside. Don't do that. Give you a little surprise. You come in, you notice that she is something, you know, not happy there. Seek, find out what's going on. Fix it. And then it's all gonna go well. If you don't do that, it will spiral out of control. It always protects. Love always protects. Love always trusts. It always hopes. It always preserves. And love never fails. If you're going to work on these qualities, your marriage will never fail. God is on your side. You're going to be just fine. However, each one of you must love his wife as he loves himself, and wife must respect her husband. Lots of weight on his shoulders. But you can eliminate that weight by following the word of God, instructions. In Ephesians chapter 5, for wives, wives, submit yourselves to your own husbands as you do to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, just as Christ is the head of the church, his body, for which he is a savior. Now the church submits to Christ, so as wives should submit to their own husbands in every way. We find in the scriptures there's a lot of instructions for wives to submit to their husbands, just as we submit to the Lord. And today God is placing him Lord over you, and Christ is the Lord over him. There is a chain of command. And if anything is disrupted, things not gonna work. So submit means повиноваться. And that's an interesting word. Повиноваться, you know what it means? It's like you give him your will. Submit. English doesn't, you know, it's kind of like military word there, but in Russian it's po vinovatsa, means be obedient, but not on that level. It meaning that do as he wishes. And if you're going to do that, you're going to trust his love, because he's going to project it onto you. He's going to love you. It's going to be easy for you, because you know that anything he wants of you, it is for your benefit, because he knows that you're happy. He has a beautiful shiny crown on his head. You're well. He is well. It should be easy to, I would not say obey, but I would say submit, повиноваться. That word has a profound, significant meaning in marriage. A lot of times, and especially in the world we live in right now with feminist movement, women think that they can do everything that the man can do. They can even fly to the moon and things like that. I mean, I would never send my wife to the moon. I mean, I like her next to me. I hope you don't do that. But when you go back to the original design, why God created you, God created you to help him accomplish what God had predestined, prepared for you. And you are the right one to do it. You possess all the qualities and qualifications, everything he needs. So it should be easy for him loving you because you will allow that love to be received by you by being obedient and submissive wife. 1 Peter chapter 3 says, wives, in the same way, submit yourselves to your own husband. Again, you see that? Two passages. Bible says there's two witnesses, two passages. So if your submission to your husband will win his heart, it says in here that even if you feel like, or if he's doing something kind of like not to your standards, not the way you like it, instead of using words of correction, instead of using some kind of ways to, by force, making him do what you like, Bible says that we should win him without words by our own behavior. It says, when they will use purity and reverence, when they will see the purity and reverence of your life. So your beauty should not come out of the outward adornment, such as elaborate hairstyles and wearing gold jewelry and fine clothes. Rather, it should be of your own inner self, the unfading beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit. Gentle and quiet spirit is much more precious dress than a $1,000 dress with $5,000 ring and $15,000 earrings. Because there is inflation on all of that stuff. It can be out of reach soon. But that gentle spirit, that beautiful respond to your husband is more than any earthly possessions. Dress yourself in it, and both of you are going to be happy. A lot of instructions to come. Life will teach a lot of lessons. If you guys need help, give us a call. We'll help you, but we know who to call is on him who has all the answers, and he has given us an instruction, the word of God. And when Joshua was possessing a brand new land, was taking Israelites into a promised land, and he had a lot of questions, God said, let this book, the word of God, not depart from you, because it will be success for everything you do. So my final instruction for you two is both of you get on a Bible reading plan every day. You can read separately, but allow time to read it together, meditate over the Word of God, because there is instructions for every situation of your life. Agree? Yes. I'm coming to part of a ceremony where you two will be pledging your lives to each other, where you will be promising each other to love for the rest of your lives. And after that, we're going to pray. I don't want you to take this time as some kind of ritual. I want you to give your flowers to your bridesmaid here and just absorb. Just take in this moment. Look in each other's eyes. Join your hands together. And as you repeat these solemn vows, remember, this is once in a lifetime. What's happening right now only happens once. Brother, microphone, you're going to go first. I, Emmanuel,
take you, Zaryana,
to be my wife, to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse,
for richer or for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
till death do we part.
And this is my solemn vow.
Today I promise to respect you always.
And I will share with you the good times and the bad times.
And be a great support for you.
And to seal this promise, I would like the rings to be brought up.
Ring man, come on, your time. While he's coming here, you guys look at each other and just remember this moment. No, I think the young man is given opportunity for them. Okay, we have a... Emmanuel, would you take the ring and place it on Zaryana's finger? As he's placing this ring on your hand right now, every time you look at it, remember the promise he made for you. His love for you is just like that ring, never ending on this earth. Zaryana, you ready for this? Mm-hmm. I, Zaryana. Take you, Emmanuel.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love you and to cherish you. Till death do we part.
And this is my solemn vow.
Today I promise to respect you always. And share this life with you. And this is my solemn vow. And this moment, would you take a ring and place it on Emmy's hand? Beautiful. Just take one moment and absorb, remember, breathe, register it. Мы будем приходить к части нашей церемонии, когда каждый из нас может принять участие. Мы будем молиться, чтобы Бог благословил этих молодых людей. Это очень ответственный момент. In this moment, during the prayer, we all gonna be witnesses of a miracle, where two people, separate people, came together, carrying two different last names, will be joined together, united by God Himself, becoming one flesh, and one people with one last name. And I invite all of you to take this part very serious. Порядок молитви буде слідуючий. Невіста і жених, вони стануть на коліна, можете вже ставати. І вони першими будуть молитися. Потім будуть молитися мами. І ми всі разом після молитви мами звершимо молитву. І тоді тато молодої і я, ми помолимося за цю молоду пару. Нехай Бог благословить, і ми всі піднімемося до молитви.
Господь мій, Бог мій, я дякую Тобі, що Ти допоміг мені дожити до цього часу. Боже, Твої милості були дуже великі наді мною все моє життя, Господь. Ти мене благословив набагато більше, чим я міг заслужити. Господь, я тобі щиро і щиро дякую за все. За своїх батьків, за сім'ю, яку я виростав. За всі твої благословення, Господь. Я дякую тобі за цей день. За те, що ти дарував сьогодні погоду. За те, що ти благословив все, Господь. Я дякую тобі за Зоряну, яку ти послав моє життя, Господь. Я вірю, що вона є від тебе, що вона є благословенням для мене, і я буду благословенням для неї. Боже, так як ти до цього часу благословив мене, я прошу, благослови нас і надалі. Ти є моя надія, Господь. Я прошу, не устав. Допоможи мені во всьому. Я надіюся тільки на тебе. Прошу, допоможи мені бути добрим чоловіком, священником для нас. Я прошу, щоб ти руководив нашою сім'єю, Господь. Допоможи до кінця нашого життя, Боже. Остатися вірними тобі, Господь. Прошу, якщо буде на це твоя воля, і ти даруєш нам дітей, Боже, благослови. Та, щоб вони були здоровими, Господь, для твоєї слави, Господь. За все я тобі ще раз і ще раз дякую, прошу надалі, благослови останній остаток цього дня, Господь, тобі нехай буде за все слава. Амінь.
Дорогой Господь, спасибо тебе за то, что ты помог нам сегодня, Господь, за то, что ты довел нас до сегодняшнего дня, ты хранил нас на всех наших путях, Иисус. Спасибо тебе за всех, кто сегодня пришел, Господь, за наших родных, близких и друзей, Господь. Спасибо тебе за то, что ты хранил их всех. Спасибо тебе за то, что ты хранил мою жизнь, жизнь Эмика, Господь, на протяжении всех этих лет. И за то, что ты свел нас вместе, Господь, и дал нам любовь. Пожалуйста, помоги нам во всем, Господь, искать твоей воли, чтобы ты был в центре наших отношений, Господь, нашей семьи, Иисус, всех наших решений, Господь. Благослови, пожалуйста, остаток сегодняшнего дня. Пусть во всем будет, Господь, Твоя воля, и пусть во всем прославится имя Твое, Господь, и через наши жизни, и через сегодняшний день, и через нашу супружескую жизнь, Господь. Я благодарю Тебя за Эмика, Господь. Спасибо Тебе за то, что он такой добрый, Господь, за то, что он такой трудолюбивый. Я о таком не могла мечтать, Боже. Спасибо Тебе, Господь, за мою семью, Господь. Спасибо Тебе за семью Эмика. И спасибо Тебе за то, что сегодня мы становимся одной семьей, Господь. Благослови нас и на дальше, Господь. Вся наша надежда только на Тебя. Аминь.
Мій добрий Боже, Господи, я все даний час пристала під Твоїм святим лицем. Я славлю Твоє ім'я за те, що до цього часу, до того дня Ти поміг і зберіг. Боже, що Ти не відняв свої милості від мого дому, від мені сім'ї. Ми всі живі, здорові, слава Тобі, Господи. Все даний час я прошу Тебе. Будь з нами благослови, Ти знаєш все, Ти знаєш серце моє, Боже. Я прошу Тебе, благослови Еміка, Ти бачиш його, Господи. Слава Тобі, що Ти посилаєш йому дружину, Ісус. Я прошу, благослови їхнє життя, поможи, збережи їх від всякого гора, нещастя, від гріха, від всяких злих, недобрих людей. Боже, я їх в руки Твої святі віддаю. Я прошу Тебе, Спасителю, Ти знаєш... Я прошу, благослови Еміка, воздай йому сам за його добре серце. Ти знаєш, як він діє. Господи, почуй мене, я моляю. Поможи, щоб вони жили в мирі, в любові, щоб все в них було добре, Господи. Щоб вони любили тебе і служили тобі, Спасителю, почуй. Слава тобі за той день, за погоду, що ти послав. За все я славлю, величаю твоє святе ім'я. Благослови Наталі, будь з нами, в руки Твої ми віддаємося святі. За все прийми хвалу і славу, вічний Бог, Отець і Дух Святий. Амінь.
Дорогой Господь, хвала Тебе і слава. Ми сьогодні приходимо Благодаря Тебе и во имя Твое. Спасибо, что когда-то Ты нашел, спас и оправдал нас. Мы тоже, Господи, стали семьей. Благодарю Тебя за детей, которых Ты послал. И сегодня по-особенному благодарю Тебя за Заряну и за Эммануила. И призываю Твое благословение, Господь. Я, как мама, благословляю своих детей. Спасибо, Господи, что Ты даровал нам еще одного сына. Я благодарю Тебя, Господи, что Ты верный Бог. И судьба человека от Господа. Все в Твоих руках. Мы оказались в этом месте, в этой церкви. Наши дети встретились. И я знаю, что начавши, Ты закончишь. Господи, благослови их весь жизненный путь. Мы знаем, Господь, что брак – это не всегда вздохи при луне, Господь, что это труд. И я прошу просто благослови, чтобы в радостные времена и во времена тяжелые, Господь, они поддерживали друг друга, были опорой, Господь. Благослови во имя Иисуса Христа их детками, Господи, чтобы мы все радовались, Господь. А я благодарю Тебя и превозношу Твое святое имя. Спасибо, что Ты с нами, Господь, что Ты всегда был, есть и будешь с нами, Господь. Аминь.
А зараз ми всі, як церква Ісуса Христа, піднімемо голос нашій молитві і помолимося, щоб Бог благословив цих молодих людей. Я отак кажу, а ти теж також. Я помишся першим.
Отець Небесний, в ім'я Ісуса Христа, я дякую за чудовий день, за чудову погоду, за всіх гостей, за це свято, за цю урочисту подію. Я дякую тобі. Я дякую, що ти дозволив цим молодим людям колись родитися. Я дякую за батьків Еммануїла, що вони його родили, виховали. І за Заряну дякую, що ми цим дітям змогли передати віру. Вони наші діти, але вони також твої діти, вічний Бог. І сьогодні вони потребують твого благословення. І ми в смиренні просимо, щоб благословення Авраама прийшло на їх життя. Я молю тебе, благослови Заряну, щоб вона була доброю помічницею для Еммануїла, щоб вона була мудрою дружиною, щоб прийшов час, вона могла тримати діток на своїх руках. Господи, ми її благословляємо на те, щоб вона була добрим вінцем для свого чоловіка в ім'я Ісуса. Я дякую тобі за Еммануїла. Вічний Господь, поможи їм бути пророком, священником, царем, господаром, добрим господаром в своєму домі. Поможи, Господі, йому так любити свою дружину, щоб їй легко було коритися йому. Я його благословляю на всяке добро, на успіх. Благослови його роботу, бізнес. Благослови, Господі, їх відношення. Господі, його благословляю як майбутнього батька. Хай вони порадують нас, мене, майбутнього діда, хай порадують. В ім'я Ісуса Христа, хай їх діти будуть здорові, гарні і благословені. Боже, благословляю їх на одну дорогу, на одне серце і на одну долю. В ім'я Отця і Сина і Святого Духа. Амінь.
Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for blessing over these two precious souls who decided to join their lives together, Lord. And as I pray right now, and I lay my hands on them, let there be your hands upon their heads and knitting their hearts together, Lord. Only you can do it. For you have predestined this from the beginning. And I ask that the blessings that come from your throne would be bestowed unto these precious two people. God, I pray that out of these two people, you will produce a great nation on this earth. People who will be known among the nations as people who love the Lord and carry the presence of God. For you have given Emmanuel this beautiful name that proclaims your presence, God. I pray that your presence would always be in their lives, Lord, and that they will never depart from you, but that they will always walk with you together, Lord, accomplishing everything that you have predestined them to do, Lord. This moment, Father, let them walk into your destiny and work together, Father, to accomplish your, to do your will in Jesus' mighty name, Father. I pray, Father, that you would bless Zaryana with health, wealth, sound mind, God, and every necessary provision to be a good wife and a helper for her husband, Father. I pray, Father, that you would be with her in all situations of life, Lord, and that your presence, God, would be a great blessing for her, Lord. Father, I pray for Emmanuel. May you bless him to be a father, Lord. May you bless him to be a priest in his family, Lord, the royal priesthood, God, upon their family. Lord, I pray, Father, that he will accomplish everything with the help of Zariana that you have sent him on this earth to do, Lord, and leave a great legacy after himself if the humanity will continue. God, I pray, Lord God, that these two people would be a great example for what Christian marriage should be, what Christian family should be, Lord. Let them be, God, blessing for so many others people, for so many other people, God. I pray, Lord, that your presence would always be with them, Lord, from this moment on. Unite them, knit them together. I pray this prayer in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Okay, you guys can stand up now. And I will ask the groomsmen to bring certificate of marriage. They are been made legal in the eyes of God to be husband and wife, and we're going to sign this document, and you will be legal in front of the people. So if I can have bridesmaids or one bridesmaid and a groomsman come here, we're going to sign the paper as you being a witness of what happened here. You ready? Igor, you sign here. Yep. Brother, you can run for office. That's a beautiful signature. Oh, one more. Okay, one more. Come back, come back, come back. Witness signature. Gentlemen, it is my privilege today to pronounce a brand new family, Zariana and Emmanuel Baltic. What God has joined together, let no man separate. And I pronounce you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You may kiss the bride. Наша частина шлюбного наставлення, вінчання, прийшло до кінця. І сьогодні усі ви стали свідками того, що утворилася нова сім'я. Моліться за них, благословляйте них. І зараз тут буде залишатися сім'я невісти, сім'я жениха, для того, щоб поздоровити їх і сфотографуватися. І самі близькі друзі. А всі останні, всі теж друзі, ви теж близькі. Ви можете проходити до весільного залу. І наша частина тут прийшла до кінця. So, friends and family, immediate family need to stay here for pictures. And everybody else, if you want to stay and congratulate the bride and the groom, you're welcome. But if you want to congratulate them in the wedding hall, you can do that too. God bless you.
Congratulations.
I was waiting so many long and lonely nights, searching, I was searching for something I could never find. But I knew in that moment when your eyes met up with mine, all my wait was over, and that's when you changed my life. The sun shines brighter when you are here. My heart beats louder and time just disappears. Everything is how it should be when you're with me. Dreamers, we are dreaming of all the days that lie ahead. Nothing, there is nothing that could take all that we have. Hold you, I will hold you through the better and the worse. Promise, oh I promise, and I'm not just saying words. The sun shines brighter when you are here. My heart beats louder and time just disappears. Everything is how it should be. And I can't stop counting my lucky stars. I always wanna be where you are. Everything is how it should be when you're with me. Dreamers, we are dreaming of all the days that lie ahead. With you, I'll be with you until the very end. Thank you.
God gave me you for the days of doubt. God gave me you for the up and down. God gave me you for the days of doubt. But when I think I lost my way, there are no words to left to say it's true. God gave me you.
Sunny days and whatever the weather, we have each other, and that's how the story will end. Well, I'll be your shade tree in summer, if you'll be my fire when it's cold. And whatever the season, well, we'll keep on breathing, 'cause we'll have each other to hold. And I'll hold you, and I'll sing. We'll carry your burden, be the wind that you're back. Well, I wanna spend my forever, forever like that. Keep changing, but love I'll keep arranging. And this is a song that we'll sing. And I'll hold you, and I'll sing. I want to love you forever, I do. I want to spend all of my days with you. Show back.
crashed in my heart. I knew that this could be the start of something like you see in movies, the making of our story. So I got down on my knee and I told you honestly, baby, I don't know where we're going, but we're going together. Baby in the back seat, we're moving to another country, and we packed up every last thing, turned a chapter in this story. Both of us scared to death, you took my hand and said, baby, I don't know where we're going, but we're going together. We're going together. Change a thing, and it might not come easy, but the beauty is the mystery of where this road leads. Baby, I don't know where we're going, but we're going together. We're going together.
Kitchen's clean, then we turn out the light. Raindrops on the window, we're on the couch. Fire in the fireplace, best seat in the house. When God made you, He already knew that we were meant to be. to be.
Got nine fancy pillows on our bed, and we've got towels she won't let anyone get wet. No, I don't get her. Cry, she always cries happy endings on TV. She even cries at some commercials in between. I don't get her. She's about as clear to me as a mystery. She's got a closet full of nothing to wear. So many shoes, she needs another pair. And when she gets to talking, Lord, you just can't stop her. She's everything I didn't know I needed. The perfect fit. God, I got her. Fine. When she says that she's just fine, that's when she's not. And she's still right, and we both know that she's dead wrong. No, I don't get her. But I smile, 'cause I can see forever in those big brown eyes. Just her touch and just her kiss. And I don't know what I'd do if I ever lost her. She's everything I didn't know I needed. The perfect fit, the missing piece. I might not get her, but you know I want her. I might not get her. Thank God I got her. Got nine fancy pillows on our bed, but thank God I got her. I told you I was on your side. I told you I would never hide. So you can put your hand in mine, 'cause I'll be keeping by your side. I'll love you till the stars turn cold, and I'll love you like this ring I hold. Yes, around, around it goes. A circle never knows the end of the line. So you will find with our love. 'Cause this love is a band of gold. When the fire's burning and when the embers feel cold. So when I hold you in my arms, I hope you know that this love is a band of gold. I'm never getting over you. No, I never will be over you. You
inside through with the key. That bomb heart to yours, to the bottom of the sea. I don't need it anymore. No, there's no turning back for us. There's only moving forward. This love is a band of gold. When the fire's burning and when the embers feel cold, so now I hold you in my arms. I hope you know that this love is a band of gold. And the stars that come and cover up the moon, they may steal starry skies we knew. They can't take away, can't take away what's true. I belong, I still belong. I belong to you. This love is a band of gold. When the fire's burning, when the embers feel.
Some days I know you see your face in the mirror, and your eyes rest on every flaw. You try to hide and cover your imperfections, but you really don't feel better at all. Don't worry, don't worry. He already thinks you're beautiful. He loves you just the way you are. And nothing you can do could ever change his point of view. He already thinks you're beautiful. You're beautiful. You're beautiful. You're beautiful, you're beautiful. There's no mistakes in how he puts you together, even when it's hard for you to see. No need to try and become somebody different. Only thing you gotta do is believe it. He already thinks you're beautiful. He loves you just the way you are. And nothing you can do could ever change his point of view. He already thinks you're beautiful. You're beautiful. You're beautiful. Beautiful, you're beautiful, you're beautiful. When you can see it, beautiful. And when you can,
beautiful.
Hope, love, it don't forget.
You're beautiful.
At your weakest,
beautiful.
And at your best. Just the way you are. Oh, and nothing you can do could ever change his point of view.